हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 51। आईक्यू हैज फाइनली कंफर्म द लॉन्च ऑफ आईक्यू 7 इन इंडिया ऑन अप्रैल 26 अलोंग विद आईक्यू 7 लेजेंड एडिशन विद स्नैपड्रैगन 888 प्रोसेसर। इट विल बी सोल्ड आउट ऑन amazon.in वेयर द लास्ट टाइम आईक्यू 3 वाज लॉन्च्ड ऑन फ्लिपकार्ट। द गैलेक्सी एम सीरीज इज वेल अप्रिशिएटेड इन इंडिया एंड द लोकल फैंस आर अप टू अनदर ट्रीट दिस मंथ कॉल्ड सैमसंग गैलेक्सी M42। द फोन विल हैव 5G कनेक्टिविटी थैंक्स टू इट्स स्नैपड्रैगन 750 चिपसेट एंड विल अराइव एज अर्ली एज दिस मंथ एंड द प्राइस ऑफ दिस फोन विल बी अराउंड 20,000 to 25,000 इंडियन रुपीज। Realme is preparing to launch its latest 8 series smartphone including Realme 8 5G and Realme 8 Pro 5G rumored to launch in India on April 22nd. Last week the company confirmed that Realme 8 series 5G smartphones will be announced on April 21st in Thailand. It also confirmed that Realme 8 5G features a 90Hz refresh rate screen, Dimensity 700 processor and a 5000mAh battery. Redmi has confirmed that it will launch its first gaming flagship smartphone in China by end of this April. The teaser has been announced at the third birth anniversary of Black Shark. It also said that the phone will be a flagship smartphone with high-end gaming features. It also said that phone will be an ultimate cost-effective gaming flagship smartphone. After announcing that, LG will be providing extended software support to its devices. The brand has now revealed a list of its smartphones that will be receiving future software updates from the brand, and some of the devices including the LG Wing are listed to get even the Android 13 update whenever it arrives officially. Siri has unexpectedly revealed the date of Apple's special event. The company is expected to reveal new iPad Pro models and long-awaited a text tracker. The event will be live-streamed on April 20th on the company's website and YouTube channel. Alibaba Group fined $2.75 billion by China for anti-monopoly violations. The Alibaba business empire has come under intense scrutiny in China since billionaire founder Jack Ma's stinging public criticism of the country's regulatory system in October. Boston Dynamics bot developed by the French Army in combat drill for reconnaissance. The French Army was recently deployed a group of robots in the simulation of a combat mission held in military school. The robotic dog named Spot, produced by US robotics manufacturer Boston Dynamics, was among several robots deployed for offensive and defensive missions in collaboration with military school students. Ultra is the new Pro and ZTE is looking to join Samsung, Xiaomi and other premium phone makers with its own Axon 30 Ultra. The flagship is set to debut on April 15th and after teasing its triple camera setup consisting with 364 megapixel sensors, ZTE is now sharing a look at the front of the device in a series of video ads. The first ad showcases the phone camera powers and its varying zoom lengths ranging from 0.5 times to 5 times optical and 20x digital. The video also shows a phone's curved screen with a centered punch hole cutout on the top. In the modern world, lithium-ion batteries are essentially everywhere, can be found powering various forms of technologies like smartphones, notebooks, wearable products and much more as well. But now researchers in Russia has developed a new type of technology that they claim can charge about 10 times faster than the existing lithium-ion batteries. This significant rise in charging rates could potentially offer huge time-saving advantages if it does eventually arrive in consumer electronic goods. A battery manufactured using our polymer will charge in seconds about 10 times faster than a traditional lithium-ion battery. This was already been demonstrated through a series of experiments. Worldwide personal computer shipments hit a total of 69.9 million units in the first quarter of 2021, showing a 32% increase from an yearly basis. COVID-19 pandemic and an increased demand for PCs has been shipments recorded a faster yearly growth since 2020. PumpPumpPump get rupees 5.5 crore funding from Inflection Point and other companies. PumpPumpPump, a startup involved in used car leasing, plans to use the funding to increase consumer awareness around the segment, technology development, brand building and expansion. Grafton, the company behind PUBG, is working on a new game. If you are thinking that it's a some form of PUBG, that's not the case. According to Players GN, the developers are working on a new open world game codenamed Vertical. This title is not for a battle royale. He claims that it is still under development and it will take approximately 2 to 3 years to release. The device Honor X20 will be powered by MediaTek processor. The device is expected to be announced in the coming months. There was no official confirmation about the same. Motorola is rumored to be working towards the launch of two new Moto G series smartphones for the Indian market. The handset Motorola is expected to soon announce in India are expected to be Moto G60 and Moto G40 Fusion, both devices are going to be powered by Snapdragon 732 chipset. While one Moto G series device will house a 108MP primary camera and a 32MP front camera. And we can also see that it will be coming up with 120Hz HDR10 display, and these devices will draw power from a massive 6000mAh battery. HTC Vive is a Taiwanese company line for VR hardware. The manufacturer is expected to announce new product, and it appears that will happen next month during the first ever HTC VivCon. Announced yesterday via official HTC Vive Twitter account, VivCon 2021 will hold next month on May 12 and May 13. The two-day event is expected to be a virtual one, and the attached image appears to be a teaser for the VR headset. Xiaomi is gearing up for the big launch event on April 23rd in India. The company has already confirmed that it is bringing the Mi 11 Ultra and the Mi 11 X series to the country. Now it has teased the arrival of new Mi TV, and it could be the 75-inch QLED TV that has recently launched in Europe. Xiaomi says a Redmi Note 10 display issue faced by 0.001% users, and company is working on the fix. And the company mentions that this matter is on top priority and regret the inconvenience caused to the consumers. Sony already has a few games and applications available for mobile users. Sony has posted a job listing for the position of Head of Mobile PlayStation Studios and SIC. Sony already has a dedicated mobile publishing label named PlayStation Mobile Company. Vivo V21 series launching in India soon. The lineup will include Vivo V21 4G and Vivo V21 5G. The Vivo V21 series will have a 64MP triple camera and a 8GB RAM and a 44MP selfie snapper. New WhatsApp law let attackers suspend your account if they have your phone number. The attackers initially request and enters incorrect multiple two-factor SMS code that will lock out WhatsApp sign-ins on their device for 12 hours. WhatsApp recommended that users provide an email address with two-factor authentication to help support executive if they run into this problem. Apple reintroduced MagSafe with the launch of iPhone 12 series late last year. All four new iPhones comes with a magnetic ring on the back for MagSafe wireless charging. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.